welcome to the groundbreaking ceremony for the Johnny Cash Trail. We've had a nice bout of rain already, but the gods of country music must have talked to Mother Nature and cleared the skies for us. And if there's a Zeus for the gods of country music, we all know it's Johnny Cash. So my name is Robert Goss. I'm the Parks and Recreation Director for the City of Folsom. It is my pleasure to be here for this ceremony. But now a little bit about the project. First of all, Folsom is known for its history. I mean, we're known for gold, trains, the Pony Express, hydroelectric power. Before all of that, Native Americans. I mean, there's all kinds of remnants of our long ago ancestors around the American River. But on January 13th, 1968, history was made again. Two concerts were performed at Folsom Prison by Johnny Cash. Those concerts were recorded and resulted in a 3x platinum record, Johnny Cash at Folsom Prison, with obviously that hit song, Folsom Prison Blues. That album and that song are probably the number one reason why people all over the world know about Folsom, California, our great little town on the shores of the American River. You might ask, you know, why a trail and why Johnny Cash? I've said this before and I'll continue to say it. I don't think Johnny Cash was much of a bike rider. But it is a great way to link Johnny Cash, what the city of Folsom is about today, our history with Folsom Prison, and our great open space network in this city. I would also say that our design engineer recognized an opportunity for a phenomenal community gateway, and I'll point to those images shortly. And we also would say, you know, why Johnny Cash and why a trail? I would say that Folsom celebrates history. Whether your name is Sutter, Judah, Liedesdorf, Nissanon, Livermore, or Cash, if you have a profound impact on this city will recognize it. So without further ado, a few stats about this project. We're about to embark on a $3 million contract. We're going to break ground literally with the contractor in just a week or two. This first phase that will link where you stand now with the trail across the street and behind you, go all the way down parallel to Natoma Street down to Prison Road, is about 7,000 linear feet or about 1.3 miles. Ultimately, the entire project is 2.5 miles long, and we hope to start that second phase within about one more year. Our Clear Span Bridge over Folsom Lake Crossing Road, which will be right to my left, will be a phenomenal gateway. Those images are right here to my right on the easels. The architecture of those abutments are taken straight off the Folsom East Gate guard towers. It's just a tremendous opportunity to recognize the work that was done at that prison over 100 years ago with a Gothic architecture theme that we're going to reinterpret in the 21st century on our gateway bike trail. This bike trail is also going to be designed for safety, both for bicyclists, pedestrians, and equestrians. This is going to be the designated route to link Lake Natoma multi-use trails where equestrians are allowed all the way to Folsom Lake behind me. As I said, we're going to start this work in the next week or two, and we plan to finish it in late summer or early fall. It's a phenomenal project, and I appreciate you coming out today between these rainstorms. So without further ado, I will introduce the 2014 mayor of the city of Folsom, Carrie Howell.
I'm thrilled that there's so many of you here. We were talking earlier that, you know, again, most people don't do groundbreakings for trails, but we do things differently in Folsom. And the only other event that I can recall having seen quite so many of you out there was the day we opened the parking structure in the historic district. It was a Tuesday, it was 110, and about 1,500 people were there. So, as I said earlier, when Folsom throws a party, everybody shows up. So I'm thrilled that we're moving forward with this project. This is something that I've been talking to Robert about for a very, very long time. Many of you remember I was disappointed with the choice of the name of the bridge behind us, and this is as good as it gets for the moment. So thanks for everybody coming out. And sorry for some of you that didn't have to, weren't expecting to have to walk quite so far, but it is a trail after all. So without any further ado for me, I'm going to introduce my new friend and very passionate about this project, here representing the Cash family, Cindy Cash. Come on up.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'd love her. Hi, everybody.
Hi.
It took me a long time to get here. This is the only venue my dad would never bring me with him on. I was about 8 years old the first time he came here, and I cried all day long. I want to go with you. And he just said, this is a picking and grinning. You can't come with me on today, honey. And I said, why? It took me about 10 more years, maybe, before I finally went, I get it. It's all men. No girls allowed. But I was trying to get a picture of my dad on a bicycle today, and I can't do it. It ain't gonna happen. It never would have happened. I never saw it. But I can get a picture of him with a walking cane, a stick he picked up off the ground, walking along this trail and loving it. Because I love this town. And I think he would really, really be excited about this. I really love it here. I want to like find a little condo here somewhere and move up here. And like I've adopted some of the people here already. Just love it here. I'm really excited. I'm thrilled that they've asked me to be a part of this and to help bring my dad, the personal side of dad, into this and help to choose some of the artwork that may, you know, go along the trail that really does speak about him. Because there's a lot of times that this, things like this happen and they don't get a real image of dad and the personal side of him. I hope I can bring that because he was a great dad. He was a great guy other than being a great artist. So I thank everybody for coming and being a part of this. And I thank you for having me.
Three. Look up. Smile. One, two, three.
But those people keep filming, and that's what tortures me. And then Jake on the bass. Lonesome whistle blowing the blues away.
All right, this is a historic moment for us right here. Cindy, I know you got the laryngitis, but I know you're down to sing the song. So it's okay. Here's the microphone right here.
Get up close, Cindy.
I remember when I was a lad, times were hard, things were bad. But there's a silver lining behind every cloud. Just poor people, that's all we were, trying to live in back then dirt. We'd get together in a family circle, singing loud.
Daddy sang bass.
Mama sang tin.
Woo! Oh, John, right in there. Singing seems to help a troubled soul. One of these days, and it won't be long, I'll join the minute zone. Gonna join the family circle, have a throne. No, the circle won't be broken. By and by, Lord, by and by.
And he sang bass.
Mama sang tenor.
Go join right in the sky, Lord, in the sky. Remember after work, Mama would call in all of us. You could see her sing for a country mile. Now her brother was done gone on, but I'll rejoin him in a song. We'd be together again up yonder in a little while.
Daddy sang bass.
Mama sang in a
singing to see the help of troubled soul. One of these days it won't be long, I'll rejoin him in a song. Family circle, have a throne. Ready, city? No, the circle won't be broken. By and by, Lord, by and by.
Daddy sang bass.
Mom sang tenor.
Close your eyes and hear the sky, Lord, in the sky.
in the sky, Lord, in the sky.
She just had the strep throat, everybody. Give it again for Cindy. That was beautiful.
Get it blues, come on, get it ready. When you get the blues, get a right roll feeling in your bones, put taps on your toes, get going, get a rhythm. When you get the blues, hi Marianne.
Oh, that's not a good time to have that.
Well, it sounds like
a
very good one.
Yeah.